What's up, scholars? We are about to go outside on a nature walk, but here's what we're going to be looking for. Yes, we're always looking for something. Why? Because we are scientists, and that's what scientists do. We observe the world around us to make rational conclusions. That's how we learn. We use our eyes and our ears and our hands and our sense of taste and our sense of smell to interact with the planet and learn things. And we're going to be looking for living and non-living things. Now, remember, for classification purposes, there's nothing difference. There is no difference between a once living thing and a living thing. What we're talking about, when we say non-living, we're saying things that have never, ever, 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 nor will ever, ever, ever have life. But how do we determine life? How do we determine that? What are the things that we look for to determine if something is living or non-living? Well, I'm about to give you a living checklist. And if you can check the boxes on this checklist, then you can say that this item was living or once living. Or you can say, because I cannot check any of these boxes, it has to be non-living. One of the things that we look for to determine if something is living or non-living is, does it move? And not like move like the wind blows and the soil is being carried, but no, not that kind of, I'm talking about, I can get up out of my chair and I can choose to walk across the room, or an ant can run across my desk, or your dog can run across to you in the yard. That is the choice. I can move whenever I want to. What can the object move? That is one characteristic. You can always ask yourself, if I'm looking at something and I set it down and I say, move, go somewhere, or I swat at it, like, is it going to move? Is it going to respond? That's another characteristic of living things. Actually, can they respond to stimuli? Some of you, if I took my finger and I poked it right here and I did, you'd be like, please stop this. Stop this. Why? Because you're ticklish. You're going to respond to what I'm doing. You respond. My dog likes, dogs like you to rub right behind their ear like that, and you get that good scratch going, right? And then they'll, I don't know about yours, but my dog, I used to do it, and I would scratch right here and he'd start kicking his back leg. His back leg would start doing this. Your dog probably does the same thing. Why? Because they are responding to the stimuli. Living things also take in nutrients. I need food. I actually have some awesome cake right here. Yes, this is amazing. It's like birthday cake, but it's not a birthday cake, but it's like, I think they call it birthday cake. That's weird though, because what if it's not my birthday? Huh, the greatest questions that scientists have to discover. Even if it's not my birthday, does birthday cake still represent a birthday? Like, what does that really mean? Why do we call it birthday cake? That's why you're here, to discover these kinds of things. Living things take in nutrients. They have to consume in order to get energy and metabolize the food into energy and all that kind of good stuff. They move, they reproduce. That means that they have offspring, they have children, they have babies. We are a product of our living parents, right? All of us came from a mommy and a daddy. They breathe. Living things breathe. So we take in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide, and other organisms take in that carbon dioxide and release oxygen. Other living things do that. So living things breathe. And last but not least is, living things excrete waste. If you've ever seen a baby with the diaper on, you know that living things excrete waste. So let's recap our list and then we're going to get out here. Living things, they move. Living things, they reproduce. Living things, they take in nutrients. Living things, they respond to stimuli. Living things breathe. Living things grow. Like, I'm grown, grown man. You're a grown child, but you gotta know your place because you're not that grown. And living things excrete waste. Those are some of the characteristics of living things. If your object does not meet those characteristics, if your object, if you cannot check those boxes for that, then it is not a living thing. For example, my pen that I'm holding right here, my pen does not move unless I throw it. My pen is not going to reproduce and pop into a whole bunch of little baby pens. My pen is not going to respond to stimuli. I can touch it all day and it's not going to choose to do anything. This doesn't bother it. It's not going to scratch itself. Like, none of that's going to happen. It doesn't breathe. It doesn't grow. And it's not going to excrete waste. It's not going to release waste. Now, if I break it, it's going to make a mess, but that's not the same thing as excreting waste. My pen is definitely a non-living thing. Living, non-living. Remember, If an object was once living, it's still classified as living because it can still check those boxes. Scholars, have an absolutely wonderful rest of your day, and we will be back on soon with more amazing science. Y'all are awesome.